What I got from the lady, because I had to work, I had a job there. It's her husband's stuff, and back in the early 80s, or mid-80s, he passed away of cancer. And all that stuff has been sitting in the attic ever since. And I guess her and her new husband decided to get rid of it. All put it out there on the outside. I do not want these.
Like I said,
the cartridges and not the cases and stuff like that. This would be great for something like that. Most of them have got the...
Well, yeah, I mean, that's the thing. I mean, packaging is always the first thing to go. I mean, I know that's something even I was bad about back then. You know, I'd get these games, and I'd just throw the packaging away. You know, my parents weren't going to have me having that stuff sitting around. You know, and then, of course, you know... But it's just, you know, it's amazing to me. This kind of goes into what I talk about a lot of the time, which is that a lot of games or a lot of this stuff is still getting wrecked. It's still getting destroyed. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, this stuff survived all that time.
Yeah, the rubber bands are holding to it, though.
He's got a price sticker.
Quite a few of them still have price stickers where you can see where there's probably like some of them got like 10 or 15 price stickers where they continually mark them down.
Check this out right
over
here.
And over again.
Target $9.99. All that time ago. And yeah, it looks like I was wondering if the guy, I guess that answers my question there. I guess he just, this guy had a lot of games back in the day.
Yeah.
This guy must have really been a gamer.
I'm pretty sure he was. He had a bunch of different controls. You could tell he had made this box where he could put multiple consoles together to one TV from back then.
Oh wow, that was, yeah.
He had got dip switches and stuff you would flip and they were all labeled. I just left that there. But it was pretty neat for what it was.
Man, that's what we got. Atari, Coleco, I mean, yeah, the guy had like every console.
There was everything in there.
Atari, Commodore, you know, some of these are like botches that even, some of these are things that I hadn't even, you know, some of these are things that I hadn't even seen before, this particular one, but, you know. Oh yeah, well see, I always liked the Coleco boxes, because they would put, I mean, you remember back then. I mean, back then, it's all arcade ports.
You get some of the arcade ports.
Like, there's almost all arcade ports, and some of the Coleco would actually put the actual games on the box, you know, and let you know, you know, I always thought that was kind of neat. And then especially for like that late 80s, you never saw the old games anymore, so the old pictures were just kind of cool. You know, this was before eBay and stuff like that, brand new off the showroom. Oh yeah, what is this right here? Oh hang on, I gotta look at that one. First of all, you gotta love the box art. I mean, back then, you gotta love it versus what the game actually looks like. That guy doesn't even look like he wants to be there.
No, he's like, man, this is so...
Yeah, he's like, I need a new agent. He's probably not even. It's probably like that's probably somebody, because the magic wasn't
they
a very big
deal. They picture of a guy like this, and then they drew the Pegasus underneath them.
No, or this probably somebody who just got hired like that. Game. You know, we're gonna bring you in the game design. You know, that's what he got asked to do.
That Popeye was $40 at Sears.
Sears, when Sears sold video games.
And then there's one right below it for $19. They just gave that one away for free.
Well, that's probably where he got a lot of these.
I think so too.
Probably right around the time of the crash. And I remember, not that far from here. I mean, you remember, there's an Ecker Drugs over there by... Where the old Kmart used to be, a little further down the south side of Garland.
Yeah, right there by 30.
Ecker Drugs in that strip shopping center across the street from there that they sold video games.
I didn't know they did.
And Ecker Drugs sold video games in the early 80s.
Well, Albertsons used to too in the.
But I remember when that Eckerd Drugs, when they decided to close them out.
Yeah.
Like the crash happened and stuff. I remember my friends going nuts, the ones that had Atari. I had a Commodore, so it was of no use to me, but my friends that had Ataris and stuff like that went nuts, and they all ride their bikes down there, because they literally had marked them all down to like $2-3.
Yeah, because it was your lunch money. Go buy you know,
that's day. What they were doing. They were going down there with like their dad's truck and coming back with, you know, with games. And, you know, and for some of them, they were doing like probably this guy did, bought multiples thinking, you know, well, hey. You know, but nobody wanted these old games or whatever for years. I mean, it's just in recent years that nostalgia has finally come back around, right?
Yep. Have you seen these?
Yeah, I've seen some of these.
Just surprised how many there are in there.
Well, they
it's
came
like you
in.
Must have grabbed. Oh, they come with all the games.
They came with all the Atari games for a little while. But you know, like anything else, you'd get multiples of them.
Yep.
Remember, not just video game, remember Transformers used to come with things, G.I. Joes and stuff, they'd come with these things. So once you had more than one or two of them.
You didn't need them no more.
Yeah.
See, I don't remember getting these back whenever I used to buy them, but.
This was still kind of an early, a little more early on. The things, you know, the special cases to the save
still
your stuff.
Send it in and see what they say.
We don't look at what's even in that. Well, that's just a P.O. box, you know, thing. You see, this is like... Hey, folks. The original PSP here. That's kind of a quick and dirty video. Not that kind of video. But some of you may have recently heard about this find. This was destined for a trash dump, and a friend of mine came along at the right time. What you're looking at here are three of the more impressive boxes of a 612 box find of vintage video game boxes. All of them have been in storage for 30 years. It literally looks like the gentleman who had originally collected these went around and bought a bunch of clearance, 1984. He carefully unpackaged all of them, stored most of them flat in these comic book boxes, and they stayed that way for this whole time. His widow, as it turns out, was throwing them away. It's a very uncommon linking logic for the ColecoVision. As you can see right down there. These boxes are, a lot of them are near mint condition, as you can see. I'm not going to pull all of them out here. I don't want to put any unnecessary wear. Like I said, these were stored for 30 years, free of air, free because of how tightly they were packed together, free of light, free of everything. And we're talking for the Atari, we're talking for the ColecoVision, the Commodore 64, Commodore VIC-20, even the Vectrex, any number of them. Now, these are, of course, not the best shots, but as you can see, you know, you're getting a pretty decent little idea. I'm just trying to give an idea of the scope of this find. And as you've already seen, there's some of the items. Now, unfortunately, there were some like this, where there's rubber bands that were kind of holding them together. This is an exception to the rule. Most of this came off, some didn't. Luckily, that's not an uncommon one. But even in the case like this, where this is a pretty common game to find in box, the boxes are in exceptional condition. I mean, this guy was very careful to carefully unfold these boxes and carefully store them. So even the commons like Combat are in exceptional condition. I mean, you just don't find them, even if you find complete in box, you just don't find them quite in as good a condition as most of these are. Not all of them are perfect. Not all of them are flawless, but quite a number of them. You start seeing, you know, more uncommons
some rare ones. We've got some Commodore VIC 20 stuff down here. Just kind of get through this. I mean, some of it is kind of put out. Some, you know, uncommon boxes for those. Switch over to another box here. And these just kind of continue. Some Mattel Aquarius, very short-lived computer. And here are some Vectrex boxes. Another very short-lived thing. And like I said, most of these things are incredibly good condition. Some of them have price tags that are dated in 1984, around the spring of 84. So it looks to me like what he did was go through and buy a bunch of games like you see here on clearance and then carefully stored them. There's a turbo for the Intellivision. It's like the only Intellivision box in the bunch. I said some of them have tape or price tags and some minor flaws. Most of them do not. Clearly not going through all of them here. Look at that, Kmart, $3. You know, buying these things on closeout and putting them out here. And 612 in all. And like I said, even the common ones are in immaculate condition, because they've been sitting here the whole time. And then you get uncommon ones all throughout here as well. Looking at some of the rarity guides, I saw some games that are very uncommon. There's a Frankenstein's Monster box for the 2600. Here's some Spectrovision games for... And yeah, I mean, we're just going down the thing. I said, just kind of a quick look. It was an amazing time for me to go digging through all of these. And I'm trying to kind of quick and show the range without making a bazillion minute video here. There's some more Spectrovision games. And then we got a handful here that were not folded, mostly because they were of a heavier stock, and a bunch of Atari catalogs, NOS, never used, so they're just taken out. We got, you know, some uncommon games like Frogger 2, Cuber's Cubes. We actually got the one that everyone's freaking out about down here, which is Cuber's Cubes for the 2600. I kind of don't want to take it out all the way yet. Mr. Deuce Castle for the 2600. We've got some ColecoVision Atom stuff in here. I'm sorry, Coleco Atom computer stuff. And I mean, just amazing, amazing find. 612 boxes, and they will be needing new homes. So, I said this is just kind of a teaser thing, just to kind of show a little bit. Clearly not showing everything. But like I said, most of them are in immaculate condition. They've been in storage for 30 years, folks. And they were saved from a trash run. They were saved from going to the dump for about 20 minutes, 30 minutes. So be grateful. Piece of history has been saved. A lot of pieces of history, 612 pieces of history have been saved. And now to ensure that they go to the next generation, folks. So, thank you for taking a look. There'll be an awful lot more on this as we continue down the road. And thank you for looking, guys. Hope you see some things you like, and stay tuned so you can learn how you can get your hands on some of these and complete your collections. Thanks, folks.